Angel's pups were a lively and communicative bunch, a 10th generation of a line first created for therapy work with children with autism. A North Star pup socialization is as rich as our vision of our kid-canine partnerships. Our work is relationship-based, with the development of empathy in our pups always our top priority. And if you think that dogs don't know or share our emotional life, think again. A North Star pup is always ready to meet you where you are at emotionally, ready to reassure you that things will be okay. They provide children with a nightlight for the darkest places that they must travel. This is the expression on North Star Lucky's face when he greeted his beloved puppy raiser, Laurie, when she returned home from major surgery. The sight of Laurie in pain had literally stopped him in his tracks. And it's not just this story and this picture that inform us here. Science is backing us up. Empathy is not beyond a well-bred and socialized pup's purview. Even if we still fall short of knowing just how to measure this elusive quality. Like love itself, you just know it when you see it. This is Lila, a therapy dog in training. She is an angel daughter from her first litter, back when Little Bear was still called Johnny Come Lately. Lila is slated to deliver our next generation of North Star's line, as well as to do therapy work at North Star. Lila has been heavily socialized, interacting with hundreds of lucky children to date, and she is the very happy product of her nature as well as her nurture. Meanwhile, my empty nest became a lonely and confusing place.
One place that resisted lockdowns and gave herd immunity a whirl is Sweden. They've been seen as sort of like the experimental country for all of this. And I have to tell you, regardless of what Atlas says, the results have not been good.
In many places tonight, politicians still monitor and control the most intimate details of your life, where you eat, who you spend time with and where, how many relatives you can invite to your wedding.
News networks officially called Georgia for Joe Biden, bringing the final electoral college votes to 306 to 232.
If a Trump march draws tens of thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands of peaceful, patriotic people to Washington, and no one's around to report it, did it really occur?
With contradicting voices, conflicting visions, I knew then that I was sinking.
Now, all of you Democratic
socialists,
because it's
dumb.
With the aid of your willing accomplishments,
institutionally corrupt. And ridiculous.
And I stopped getting up with the sun. Raising Angel's pups through the pandemic was a huge distraction for me. For a while, up meant down, and right meant left. And I wasn't able to hug my mother for a month of Sundays.
Hi, Aaron, this is your mother. Old Bull as well. Chris and Jesse had the baby. It's a boy. He has brown eyes.
And then in December, my mother had to have heart surgery. Without me.
As you know, I'm going in tomorrow. It's going to be 1, 2, 3 fast. She'd feel much, much better.
Depression is a thief. It robs you of energy, even while wrapping around you as if it were a comforter. And that's just fucking lonely. I'm so lonely. Babies I couldn't hold. A mother I couldn't hug. And a world I couldn't even come close to saving. Depression is a liar. It whispers that you are not needed and that no one in the world needs you. But I have walked this road before. And I knew the day would come when I could feel music again. Or drink in a painting with more than just my eyes. Or taste a delicious poem. Or the incredible sweetness of love. And I knew that when the numb began to fade, and just as I pulled away from Prozac City, speeding up to merge with others and finding myself singing quite along, I knew that's when it would happen. That sharp stab of regret, the painful memory, or the lingering ache of longing. And I know I will remember to put one foot in front of the other, again, and then over again, till the rhythm of life sweeps me up. I happen to love children and puppies, and I spent as much time as I could with both that long ago summer that I founded North Star. But despite the joy this decision brought us as a family, it wasn't always an easy path to walk. With the hardest thing to bear, the pain of the children who came to us for help. Children who are being bullied. Families who are overwhelmed. Little ones forced to live with the devastating loss of a parent. It was quite sobering for us to have nothing to offer them but a golden pup and a wide open heart. And as crazy luck would have it, it ended up my pups were quite enough to make a difference.
Patty is the executive director of the North Star Foundation, which trains assistance dogs.
And the first thing to melt away with North Star's work were the state borders. And then the artificial separations of countries. And finally, the false gulf of political parties that threatens now to divide us. We, the people, who know we belong together. We, the people, who should be standing together now. We, the people, who are the only ones that can help our children to reach their better tomorrow. All of our children, because I know there's no such thing as an alien child or a baby who was ever born anything less than perfect. And I have some days now that I'm not only walking fast and steady, I have some days I find myself flying. Those are the days I sense the energy of others beside me. When I know I'm in good company. I know there's others behind us, still waiting for their civil rights. Those who need to be heard, but are without a traditional voice. Those who can't march, or have a ridiculously early curfew imposed by the wall of moms. And you just don't want to mess with them. So ring the bells that still can ring. Forget your perfect offering. There is a crack in everything. That's how the light gets in.